guys. Good morning. Good afternoon. Good day to everyone around the world. This is my video today is International Convention for the Prevention of Pollution from Ship 7378. Please click the subscribe button so that you will be notified on my next videos. This is my MARPOL video 5, Annex 4, Prevention of Pollution by Sewage from Ships. This annex was entered into force on September 27, 2003. Introduction: after viewing this video, you will be able to discuss recommendations and international effluent standards. Explain the different sewage treatment systems on board and explain the cooperation of each sewage plant. Explain standard discharging connection and state the conditions when discharging sewage is allowed or permitted. Discharging of sewage at sea or territorial waters is banned, as it can drastically affect the marine life. In case the sewage is to be discharged, first, it has to be treated with the help of a sewage treatment plant. It is now mandatory on every ship, according to international legislature. All sewage constituents are biodegradable and not all take at the same time to break down. Also, untreated sewage has solid particles which take a lot of time to disinfect. It is for this reason that a sewage treatment plant is used. Raw sewage in the water needs oxygen to break down naturally. This sewage, when disposed to the sea, absorbs excessive oxygen and thus reduces the requisite amount of oxygen needed. This is an example of an international sewage pollution prevention certificate. Sewage system requirements. Number one, a sewage treatment plant, which shall be of a type approved by the administration, taking into account the standards and test methods developed by the organization. If we say organization, that is the IMO. Number two, a sewage comminuting and disinfecting system must be approved by the administration. Number three, a holding tank of the capacity to the satisfaction of the administration for the retention of all sewage, having regard to the operation of the ship, the number of persons on board, and other relevant factors. These are examples of big sewage treatment plants. Sewage discharge requirements. Untreated sewage. Sewage must be retained in holding tanks, and discharge must take place at least 12 nautical miles from the nearest land. And the discharge rate must be approved by the flag state, and the ship is proceeding en route at a minimum speed of 4 knots. For comminuted and disinfected sewage, discharge must take place at least 4 nautical miles from the nearest land. The equipment must be MARPOL compliant and approved by the flag state. And the ship is proceeding en route at a minimum speed of 4 knots. For treated sewage, the treatment plant must be MARPOL compliant and approved by the flag state. And there are no floating solids or discoloration of the surrounding discharge. Types of sewage plant. We have a chemical method sewage plant. Basically, storage tank which collects solids material for disposal in permitted areas or sewer collection facilities. This system must therefore collect and store sewage produced while the ship is in controlled area. Biological system, sewage plant, utilizes bacteria to completely break down the sewage into an acceptable substance for discharge into any waters. The extended aeration process provides a climate in which oxygen-loving bacteria multiply and digest the sewage, converting it into sludge. This is an example of a sewage plant. Biological system sewage plant. Another type of sewage plant is electrocatalytic oxidation plant. The sewage is collected, macerated, and passed through an electrolytic cell. Electrolysis produces sodium hypochlorite, which is used to oxidize organic material before discharge. Alternately, dosing by chlorine may be used. The effluent passes on through a settling tank where the oxidation process is completed. This type of plants can be 50% smaller than biological types. This and the fact that pass-through sometimes are extremely several biological units are the main disadvantage system. Well, electrocatalytic oxidation. The discharge contains no solids and is totally free of coliform bacteria. A disadvantage of the system is due to the short exposure time in the oxidizer. Relatively high levels of chlorine are required to ensure destruction of the coliform bacteria. It is possible that this chlorine level can be present to some degree in the discharge. Dechlorination plant may be fitted. These types of sewage is an electrocatalytic oxidation sewage plant. Standard discharge connection, number one. The enable pipes of resection facilities to be connected with the ship's discharge pipeline. Both lines shall be fitted with a standard discharge connection in accordance with the table below. This description outside diameter, 210 millimeter. Inner diameter according to pipe outside dimension. Bolt circle diameter is 170 millimeter. sludge implants for holes 18 millimeter in diameter, equidistant, placed on a bolt circle for the above diameter, slotted to the plant's peripheral. The slot width is to be 18 millimeter. Plant thickness is 16 millimeter, and the bolts and nuts quantity and diameter for each of 16 in diameter and suitable bolts. The flange is designed to accept pipes up to a maximum internal diameter of 100 millimeter and shall be of steel in other equivalent material having a flat face. This flange together with a suitable gasket shall be suitable for a service. For ships having a molded depth of 5 meters and less, the inner diameter of the discharge connection may be 38 millimeters. Discharging of sewage, number one. Sewage which is not comminuted or disinfected at a distance of more than 12 nautical miles from the nearest land, provided that in any case, the sewage that has been stored in holding tanks shall not be discharged instantaneously, but a moderate rate when the ship is en route and proceeding not less than 4 knots. The rate of discharge shall be approved by the administration based upon standards developed by the organization or IMO. Or number two, the ship has in operation an approved sewage treatment plant, which has been certified by the administration to meet the operational requirements referred to in Regulation 9.1.1 of this annex. And the test results of the plant are laid down in the ship's International Sewage Pollution Prevention Certificate. And additionally, the effluent shall not produce visible floating liquids nor cause discoloration of the surrounding water. Number three, the provisions of paragraph one shall not apply to ships operating in the waters under the jurisdiction of the state and visiting ships from other states while they are in these waters and are discharging sewage in accordance with such less stringent requirements as may be imposed by such states. When the sewage is mixed with waste or wastewater covered by other annexes of MARPOL 7378, the requirements of those annexes shall be complied with in addition to the requirements of this annex. Revised Annex 4 entered into force on September 27, 2008. The revised Annex 4 applies to new and existing ships engaged in international voyages which are of 400 tons gross tonnage and above. Number two, certified to carry more than 15 persons. Number three, existing ships shall comply with the provisions of the revised Annex 4 5 years after the date of entry into force of the annex. Number four, the ship to which Annex 4 applies shall be equipped with either a sewage treatment plant or comminuting and disinfecting system or in a holding with holding tanks. Discharge exceptions. A ship has in operation an approved sewage treatment plant. Number two, discharging comminuted and disinfected sewage using an approved system at a distance of more than not 3 nautical miles from the nearest land, or is charging sewage which is not comminuted or disinfected at a distance of more than 12 nautical miles from the nearest land. Spatial areas. We have the Northwest European waters, Mediterranean Sea area, Baltic Sea area, Black Sea area, Red Sea area, Gulf area, Antarctic area, wider Caribbean region, and the Gulf of Aden area. This is an aerial view of a sewage pollution. Another aerial view of pollution. This is the end of my video. Thank you for viewing this video. My next video will be MARPOL video 6, which is MARPOL Annex 5. Please click the subscribe button so that you will be notified on my next videos. This is Chief Engineer Jose Garcia Abogan, PhD. Please like and subscribe to my channel to view my next videos. Thank you. Bye-bye.